So, wanted to make my video about hope. Hopefully I got the phone adjusted right this time. I noticed I was in the upper left portion, but there is great hope. You know, it's, you know, you look at, well, I got to call him for what he is, that bumbling fool in the White House. And I, you know, I think that, you know, we're getting a little bit of buyer's remorse from the idiots that, put the current president in office. I think he is a little bit cognitively challenged, let's just to say that, not trying to be mean or anything. You know, the people that don't just listen to CNN or MSDNC or NBC or CBS, you know, all of the propaganda arm of the Democrat Party, you know, if they did vote for Biden, I think they're rethinking things at this point. Because they will have learned that there were a number of lies that were told about Trump. You know, the lab that we talked about in the previous video, my Billy Bob video. And then, of course, you got the hoax where he held the Bible up in front of the church, that he tear gassed all those peaceful protesters that were burning down the church. That's peaceful, all right, especially, you know, a landmark like that church was. And among other things that went on that day. So, you know, it's kind of, so you're saying, okay, well, how's that hope, you know? Well, in 2 years, you know, you could see a red wave of, assuming the election takes place. Now, you know, my premise is that we'll be under martial law by that time, because I do think we're going to have a real estate crash and a stock market crash, and with all of the illegal immigrants that Biden's pouring into the country. And I've already talked about, you know, why I think they're doing that. You know, they're going to get a lot of slavery out of those indentured servants that are coming across, because they're not even citizens of the United States. You know, the plantation owners are taking over. The Democrat plan, socialist, Marxist, communists are taking over. But, okay, boy, that's not sounding very hopeful, is it? But anyway, so I guess what I'm trying to say is that even in the places where people just don't follow along at all, don't care, you know, just don't give a crap, you know, inflation has come. Now, you know, okay, this is going to be a bold statement. I think probably one of the greatest things that happened for the United States was for Biden to get elected. Because if Trump had been in there, inflation was coming, folks, whether it was Biden or Trump. Now, Biden's... he's hastening it along. I mean, I ain't lying. You know, Trump probably would have just done a couple trillion. Biden's, he's up towards a 6 trillion and going, you know. So he put inflation on steroids. So it's going to happen very rapidly. And, you know, and that's a good thing. That's a good thing because, you know, if inflation just trickles in, you know, it's easy to bury your head in sand and say, okay, you know, today my corn costs 10 cents more. But it's another thing when it costs 10 cents more this week, and it costs 10 cents more the following week, and then it costs 20 cents more the next week. You know, the other thing is that Biden did, which was great, he killed that Keystone Pipeline. Talk about buyer's remorse. A lot of those Keystone Pipeline guys are union members, and they voted for Biden. And man, can you imagine how pissed off you'd be if the guy you just voted in just nixnayed your $150,000 job? Do you think those guys are going to vote Democrat? I mean, I bet they're seriously reconsidering their politics about right now. So, you know, so there's hope. You see what I'm saying? There's hope. Yeah, there's a lot of things that he's done. I mean, you know, just to, I know people don't pay attention to this one, but just to rejoin the World Health Organization, which is owned by China, you know, I'm hoping that some people are looking at that going, scratching their heads going, why? You know, or rejoin the Paris Accords, you know. Hell, China and India are not even in that. You know, they don't have to obey those Paris Accords. All it does is hurt the United States. You know, wiping out all of the exploration for oil. Now, that's another thing. See, under Biden, you know, and I do hope he's going to get blamed by the people that don't vote, you know, or just, I shouldn't say don't vote, the people that don't pay attention to politics or don't pay attention to the news. Okay, they're going to feel that pinch. They're going to feel that pinch in their wallets as the gas prices go up. You know, right now I'm looking at buying a Toyota Prius Prime. Okay, now that's classified as an electric vehicle because it does, you can run 25 miles in that vehicle on an electric charge. And you're saying, well, that's just a silly, Kirk. Why would you buy something like that? You can't even get to your campsites where you want to go. True, true. But I do think with the Green New Deal and everything, I would like to have a gas sipper and be in the woke crowd, so to speak. Plus, I've always been very conservative in my vehicles anyway. I always wanted good gas mileage. It just makes common sense. Unless you need towing capacity or cargo room, or you got a family, I mean, a Prius, well, I mean, even if you had a couple kids, small kids, it would make perfect sense. Now, we're back in the parking garage, so you're going to get some car noise. Here comes a big pickup truck going by, you know, but sorry about that. But I can't get out of here. I've been at the damn hospital for 8 days, man. They won't let me go. Oh my God, the number of tests that have been run, and tomorrow I get my colonoscopy. You don't need to hear my medical problems. And that's why I'm making these videos in the damn parking garage. I know it seems silly. So, you know, what are other positive signs that you can look to? You know, I think the Federal Reserve is going to get called into question for the first time since 2013. There's a lawsuit going up against them. You know, do we still have any gold in this country? Is the United States completely bankrupt? You know, these are the questions that are going to get answered under the Biden administration. And as all this stuff comes out, you know, if this had been, and this is why I said it's a positive thing that Biden got elected. If this all the shit had hit the fan underneath Trump, he would have gotten blamed for everything when he really didn't have anything to do with any of this stuff. Hell, Biden really doesn't have, well, Biden does have a lot to do with it because he's been in Washington, D.C. for 72 damn years or however long it is. I don't know. I think he was there when the Founding Fathers were signing the Declaration of Independence, for all I know. You know, but Trump, you know, they would have, the media, the propaganda arm of the Democrat Party would have figured out a way to blame Trump for everything that's taking place right now. And so now they're going to be scrambling to somehow, you know, deflect and spin everything that's going on under the Biden administration. Now, how successful they'll be at that, I tell you, they pushed that Russian hoax for 3 years. That was pretty amazing when it was a completely false story. They pushed the Ukrainian hoax all the way up to impeachment when it was really Biden who did the quid pro quo. I mean, talk about a masterful, you know, propaganda campaign. I mean, so the media is still strong. I mean, it's hard to believe that with the number of lies that have been told, you know, even about the virus coming out of the Wuhan lab, you know, they're still spinning that. You know, it's just obvious to everybody, but they're still spinning it. And there's about a quarter of the population, at least in the United States, that still believe it came from somebody eating a bat. You know, it's just, you know, you can't, the stupidity of people is knows no bounds. Okay, you know, all you got to do is watch some of the liberals on TV. You know, hey, there's another one that gives you hope, okay? Defund the police. That's not popular anywhere, okay? Now, I understand the Democrats own the cities. You know, those people are just, well, I hate to say it, they're uneducated. You know, by design, you know, the Democrat Party took over those educational institutions and you know, the minorities in those cities, they don't get an education. So they're really, you know, and I'm not saying this in a mean way, but they're ignorant. They're very ignorant and they're easily guided, easily manipulated. And they certainly don't understand what's in their own self-interest. So they'll probably continue to vote Democrat, even though, you know, the police have been defunded, crime has gone up, there's shootings in the streets, you know, the cities are burning down, the businesses have left. And they'll still vote for the damn Democrats. And it's just, you scratch your head and you go like, wow, how can that be? But it's just, I guess it's the power of lack of education. And that's what the Democrats want. They don't want people to be smart and look at the world around them and question things, you know. The censorship, I think the censorship's gonna backfire. You know, now it's coming out that Fauci was in cahoots with Zuckerberg, and they were working to suppress the story together, that the Wuhan lab was the origin of the virus. So, you know, there's going to be, now Florida, and we just passed the law here that, we were saying that they're supposed to be a community forum, and they cannot deplatform conservative candidates from Facebook during an election. It's a step. It's a step in the right direction. But as long as big tech remains the media propaganda arm of the Democrat Party, it's going to be hard to make big progress against them, such as a antitrust, breaking them up or anything like that. The best thing that you can do if you do watch this video is, just use alternate media. Why are you on Facebook? If you're watching this video, why the hell are you on Facebook? Unless it's for your business, I understand that. But, or on Tweet. Tweet is just a cesspool of garbage in my mind. There's the people on there are nasty. They troll you. There's bots on there. Go to a place like Parler. Parler is improving their platform daily. Now, I don't know about Gab. There's a recent article that somebody, I guess the Democrats are going to publish all of the conservative correspondence on Gab. Somehow it got stolen or whatever because of lack of security. I don't know any truth to any of that. But that was a news story. I'm not on Gab, but I do want to look at it. And you got Telegram and Odyssey. So there's all kinds of, there's no reason. I understand you got liberal friends, they want to stay on Facebook, and you want to be tuned in to what's going on around you or whatever. But this is your opportunity to step up and do just a little teeny bit and say, hey, why don't we go over here to Gab, where we know that they're not monitoring everything we do and selling our personal information and exploiting us, and get off of Facebook. Who knows? Maybe a couple, three people might follow you, and then you could have your own little private group or whatever. And I say Gab. I'm not sure if Gab's that type of forum because I'm not there. But there are forums where you can go and do that sort of thing. All right. So I guess I don't know. I maybe tie it off. I'm gonna kind of walk around. I'm in the in the damn parking garage again, like I said. And I'll think on things, and maybe I'll tack something else up onto this video that I didn't mention. But you got to fight back, and there's always hope. You got to run for school boards, to get on the school boards to counter the woke message there. You've got to get into your local politics, because I think at the local level is where we're going to make the most difference, not at the national level. That's almost a lost cause until we can get the MAGA Republicans in there, which I think will happen in 2022 if we have an election. It's going to be a gradual process, to take back the country. It can happen. And that's why I said this is the hope video. And I just wish you all luck. And do the best you can. The silver squeeze is still going. I'm telling you, if you're a conservative, I really think that you need to park your money somewhere that it's going to be safe. If the financial crisis hits, and if the stock market gets cut in half, in my mind, it's going to go down by 60% at the very least. And the housing market's going to crash just like it did in 2008. So, if your house is worth $200,000 now, expect it to be worth $80,000. These things are coming, in my humble opinion. And these are things, the steps that you can take to help the country, to help yourself, to be a good American. Teacher, that's another thing, whether you homeschool or not, you should be involved in your children's education in one way, shape, or fashion. If that just means sitting down and helping them with their homework, then so be it. At least you see what the curriculum is and what they're being taught. If I had kids, which I never did, not by design, it's just I'm an ugly short troll. Get out there and help your kids and see what they're being educated about. Talk to them about school, especially if you've got them in public school. Anyway, peace out. And if I think anything to talk about, but I just wanted to give you hope. There is hope, people. And like I said, Biden getting elected, probably the greatest thing for the country that could possibly be. Because if Trump was in there, when all the crap hits the fan, as it will in the next three and a half years, he would have been blamed for everything. And this way, Biden's in there. Now, they're going to do everything they can to spin everything off of Biden. And hell, they'll probably try to look back and blame it. I'm predicting this now. They're going to try to blame it on the previous administration and say it was because of this and because of that. But That shit just ain't gonna stick. I don't think. I mean, it will stick with some people, but I think by and large, the large majority of the United States, you know, who have had some sort of education, are gonna see right through that smoke screen. So we'll see. We'll see if I'm right. All right, guys. Peace out, and I guess stay safe. Told you I'd think of something to add to the video. Let's get on to Kamala Harris. Okay, now she was put in charge of the border. It's kind of crazy because it's a political embarrassment for her of monumental proportion. And one I don't think that Biden expected her to solve. And somehow, I guess he wanted her to be politically embarrassed. The fact that she still hasn't visited the border almost 80 days or however long it's been, you know, it's just incredible. And I think even the liberal, crazy people are looking at it. I know the moderate Democrats are saying, what the heck is going on? You know, the ones that get outside of the box, the ones that might look at something besides MSDNC or the propaganda arm of the Democrat Party, because they're spinning this thing as best they can. But it's hard to spin when she shows up in Guatemala and they got signs, Kamala, go home, Trump won. I mean, that was hilarious, wasn't it? Oh, man. And then the president of Guatemala coming out and calling her to task, like, look, this is a mess of your own making. You know, Trump had things under control and you guys messed everything up. By design, as I talked about in the previous video. But you talk about buyer's remorse. I think in 2022, we're going to see her as president, because I believe that they will have to remove Biden, because as he deteriorates further, I honestly think he has Alzheimer's. And then you're going to have Kamala Harris as president. And I just can't imagine a cackling president that's going to laugh every time she comes under pressure. You never know, people rise into the job, but sometimes there's just people that are just ill-equipped to rise into a leadership position, and I feel that she's one of those people. And I just have a feeling that most people are just going to look at her as president and just say, oh my God, what did I do? Why on earth did I vote for Biden? And so that's an even bigger catalyst to spur in a red wave in 2022, and then in 2024 it could be a landslide. Hopefully, it's hard to say, because you get into, but here I'm in Gainesville. This is a Democrat city here in Florida, and even then I was watching Barnes and Fye, which I've encouraged you to watch. He was down in Miami-Dade. In Miami-Dade County, they're still enforcing mask regulations and social distancing and lockdowns. Even though the governor of Florida has said, you don't need to wear a mask. He's been saying this since June, because it's a Democrat area, they're still doing the same, they're following the Democrat, mantra. Let's all lock down, let's all wear a mask. So it's hard to believe that goes on here in Florida. Now, Gainesville's not as bad, but here at the VA, you can't go anywhere in the VA without wearing a mask, even though we all know that if you're vaccinated or you've had the virus, there's no need to wear a mask. You can't get the disease. But everybody here is still wearing masks. It doesn't make any sense. But I'll tell you, it's an incredible thing to watch in these Democrat cities, how everybody just toes the line. And of course, that's part of the Biden administration. He's telling everybody to wear masks. So anyway, I just thought I'd throw that in there. I can't even imagine a Kamala Harris presidency and what that's going to look like. So hope, people, there's always hope. So I thought I'd add one last clip here to the hope video. What I find funny is Hollywood is replete with examples of conservatism, and when you look at Star Wars, in fact, that'll be in the title of this video, is A New Hope. The reason I wanted to tack this on is Rohan, if you've watched Lord of the Rings, is answering the call. Florida is sending law enforcement to Texas to help out with the border crisis that Biden has engineered to flood the United States with slaves With the illegal immigrants, that's what they're going to be, is slaves in this country, because they cannot exist without government subsidies, and those will come with strings attached. They'll have no freedom. I'm hoping other Republican states will answer the call, and it's a new hope. Let's hope that the states, we need a convention of the states, and we'll see where all this goes. I'm just so proud of our government, Governor DeSantis. We have answered the call. Yes, indeed.